According to the international consensus statement, the return to play process is a 6-step return to play. If you look at the return to learn process, it's a 4-step return to learn. When you're dealing with adolescents, the recommendation from Davis in 2017, which was a systematic review, they kind of informed the Berlin consensus document. They said that return to learn should be completed before return to play is initiated. And what you get is a 10-step protocol. And so that's all we've done in our protocol is put the return to learn in front of the return to play, just to put more steps into the process. Just relying on symptoms for an individual is actually inadequate. The brain takes longer to recover from a metabolic or functional standpoint than it does for the symptoms to go away.